February is American Heart Month, and a heart specialist shares timely information on coronary artery disease, the most common type of heart disease and the leading cause of death in the U.S. in both men and women. We ask a specialist this morning, Dr. Rami Badawi of the Queen's Heart Physician Practice over the Queen's Medical Center. Good morning to you, Doctor. Good to have you here again.
Good morning.
A little bit about coronary artery disease. What is it? What are the symptoms? How can it be treated?
So, coronary artery disease, or heart artery disease, is essentially disease of the blood vessels mm-hmm. that supply the heart muscle with blood, which carries, as we know, the oxygen and other nutrients that are important for that heart muscle. And in terms of signs and symptoms, patients will notice as you get accumulation of calcium and cholesterol deposits, the blood flow is reduced, as depicted here in this drawing here.
What can we see? What are we seeing here, sir?
What you're seeing here is the heart artery is that travel on the surface of the heart, mm-hmm. and what happens over time is you get encroachment or narrowing because of calcium and cholesterol deposits as we get older, and eventually there's not enough blood flow to the muscle, and that's experience. What we experience then is chest discomfort or angina or breathing difficulties when
some
we try and
symptoms.
Do things.
Yeah. And treatment-wise?
So treatment-wise, you can use tablets or medications like aspirin, cholesterol-reducing tablets. Then there's been open-heart surgery for many years, and the third option is, as depicted here in this particular picture, are these mesh-like tubes called stents. Mm-hmm. These can be inserted through small puccas made in the arms or the legs that are then, and these are then delivered to the heart arteries and just used to part open the narrowed artery.
Technology has certainly improved in
Indeed.
Many years.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, coronary chronic total occlusion, CTO. What is that, and how does this apply to many islanders?
Right. So the chronic total occlusions, or coronary CTOs, as mm-hmm. we call them in short, represents a complete closure of the vessel from the encroaching calcium and cholesterol deposits, to the point that in the past we've had very little options other than open heart surgery, because it's a bit like a concrete block or a tunnel. Mm-hmm. We can't push through them to deliver these mesh-like tubes, and so really patients' options usually are just open heart surgery, where the surgeon will take either a conduit from the vein or the arteries the patient has themselves and use that as a bypass or a highway to go around the blockage. But over the last few years now, we have new options, which is why I came here to talk to you.
Yeah, a little bit about those options, because are they less invasive, if you will?
Right. So we basically have new technologies over the last 3 or 4 years that now allow us to deliver these mesh-like tubes even across these complete blockages. And that's through finer and smaller equipment, which, again, there's the usual miniaturization that we've seen in all technologies. And that allows us essentially to offer patients who before perhaps couldn't or wouldn't undergo open-heart surgery an alternative, and those who can't undergo a second surgery, let's say their previous surgery has run its course and now those grafts has failed, they have an alternative.
Because the truth of the matter is, some of those surgeries can be high risk.
Of course.
Yeah, and so this gives an option that doesn't have to have so much risk in it, if you
Right.
Yeah.
So you basically opened new options for patients that didn't exist before.
How, I mean, when you think about technology and how things have improved even in the last 5 years, It's all about staying with the times, even as a doctor mm-hmm. and as a patient, we all benefit.
That's right.
Yeah. All right, doctor, thank you very much. We appreciate you always coming to talk about this. Again, this is a very important month in February, American Heart Month. Dr. Badawi, by the way, is part of the Queens Medical Center staff out there. They earn offered many services to physicians. Go to our link, kh12.com, to learn more about what they do and how they save lives in our community. Thank you, doc.
Thank you.